The Lord be with you. I'm Deacon Keith Fournier, and our first reading is from the second book of Samuel. Once the king had settled into his palace, and Yahweh had granted him rest from all the enemies surrounding him, the king said to the prophet Nathan, "Look, I am living in a cedar wood palace while the ark of God is under awnings." Nathan said to the king, "Go and do whatever you have in mind, for Yahweh is with you." But that very night, the word of Yahweh came to Nathan. "Go and tell my servant David, Yahweh says this, are you to build me a temple for me to live in? This is what you must say to my servant David. Yahweh Sabaoth says this, I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be the leader of my people Israel. I've been with you wherever you went. I got rid of all your enemies for you. I am going to make your fame as great as the fame of the greatest on earth. I'm going to provide a place for my people Israel. I shall plant them there, and there they will live and never be disturbed again. Nor will they be oppressed by the wicked anymore as they were in former times, ever since the time that I instituted judges to govern my people Israel. And I shall grant you rest from all your enemies." And Yahweh further tells you that he will make you a dynasty. Your dynasty and your sovereignty will ever stand firm before me, and your throne be forever secure. And our response is taken from Psalm 89. For you have said, love is built to last forever. You have fixed your constancy firm in the heavens. I've made a covenant with my chosen one, sworn an oath to my servant David. I've made your dynasty firm forever, built your throne stable age to age. The heavens praise your wonders, Yahweh, your constancy in the gathering of your faithful. So I shall make him my firstborn son, the highest of earthly kings. I've established his dynasty forever, his throne to be as lasting as the heavens. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. His father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke this prophecy. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, for he has visited his people, he has set them free, and he's established for us a saving power in the house of his servant David, just as he proclaimed by the mouth of his holy prophets from ancient times, that he would save us from our enemies and from the hands of all those who hate us, and show faithful love to our ancestors, and so keep in mind his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, that he would grant us free from fear, to be delivered from the hands of our enemies, to serve him in holiness and uprightness in his presence all our days. And you, little child, you should be called prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare a way for him, to give his people knowledge of salvation through the forgiveness of sins, because of the faithful love of our God in which the rising sun has come from on high to visit us, to give light to those who live in darkness and the shadow darkest death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The Gospel of the Lord.